Hello all, today in this video we are going to solve some problems on forced convection in internal flow, that is flow through cylinders. Now go to the problem. In the problem it is given that in a long annulus which is having internal diameter of 3.125 cm and OD of 5 cm, so D naught equal to 5 cm. Di equal to 3.125 cm. You know that which is equal to 0.05 meter. This is equal to 0.03125 meters. Okay. The air is heated by maintaining the temperature of outer surface of the inner tube, that is the outer surface of the tube, at 50 degrees Celsius. So the wall temperature TW equal to 50 degrees Celsius, and the air enters at 16 degrees Celsius and leaves at 32 degrees Celsius. So TMI equal to 16 degrees Celsius, TM naught equal to 32 degrees Celsius. Its velocity is 30 meter per seconds, U equal to 30 meter per seconds. Estimate the heat transfer coefficient between air and the inner tube. So to find heat transfer coefficient H value, so in the solution first thing you have to take the properties of the flowing liquid. The flowing liquid here is air. Okay, solution T mean equal to Tm naught plus Tmi divided by 2. It is 32 plus 16 divided by 2 equal to 24 degrees Celsius. At 24 degrees Celsius, the flowing liquid is air, no? So you have to take the properties of air, dry air. So from page number, data book, page number 34, you can take the properties of air. Rho equal to 1.185 kilogram per meter cube. Rho equal to 15.53 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square per seconds. PR equal to 0.702. K equal to 0.02684 watt per meter Kelvin. These are the properties I have taken from the data book. As the second step of your problem, you have to find out the Reynolds number value, Re equal to Ud divided by nu. Here the diameter is nothing but your equivalent diameter. Since the outer diameter and inner diameter values are given in the problem, you have to take the equivalent diameter. You know that for the tube, the inner diameter is nothing but 4a divided by perimeter, which is equal to 4 into pi by 4 into d naught squared minus di squared. This equation already we told in the last video itself, no? D naught minus di into pi. So if from this equation you can find out the equivalent diameter as 0.01875 meters. Okay, now substitute this diameter value in Re equation. Your velocity is 30 into 0.01875 divided by the new value is 15.53 into 10 to the power minus 6. Then you can get the Reynolds number value as 36.2 into 10 to the power 3, which is greater than 2300. So turbulent flow. Okay, the next step you have to take the formula for Nusselt number. Here Re is greater than 10,000, so the Nusselt number equation will become nu equal to 0.023 Re power 0.8 PR power n. So the N value is 0.4 for heating processes, 0.3 for cooling processes. Now the inlet temperature is 16 degree Celsius, outlet temperature is 32 degree Celsius. Since the temperature increases from the inlet to the outlet, the process is heating process. So N equal to 0.4. Okay, now the formula will become 0.023 Reynolds number power 0.8 Pr power N, which is equal to 0.4. Now the Nusselt number equation will become 88.59. So this is equal to HD divided by K. From this equation you just find out H value as 124.4 watt per meter square Kelvin. Okay. Now in the next problem, just write the given data as water flows through 30 centimeter diameter tube. So D equal to 30 centimeter, which is equal to 0.3 meter at the rate of 60 kilogram per minute. So m dot equal to 60 kilogram per minute, which is equal to 1 kg per seconds. Okay, the tube surface is maintained at 80 degree Celsius. So the wall temperature TW equal to 80 degree Celsius. If the temperature of water increases from 10 degree Celsius, that is TM inlet temperature is 10 degree Celsius, to 30 degree Celsius. So TM naught equal to 30 degree Celsius. Find the length of the tube. So find L. Okay. Now in the solution, the first step you have to take the properties of the water. Before that, find the T mean temperature. T mean is 10 plus 30 divided by 2, which is 40 divided by 2 equal to 20 degrees Celsius. So at 20 degrees Celsius, the flowing liquid is water. No, at 20 degrees Celsius, properties of water from page number, from HMT data book. From HMT data book, just write the page number from the data book, and the values are rho equal to 1000 kilogram per meter cube, nu equal to 1.006 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square per seconds, Prandtl number Pr equal to 7.02, conductivity value is 0.597 watt per meter Kelvin, CP for water is 4178 joule per kilogram Kelvin. Okay, you have to take all the properties from the data book. Next step, find out the Reynolds number value equal to UD divided by nu. So now the U value is not directly given in the problem. Instead of U value, they gave the mass flow rate. So mass flow rate equal to rho A U. Okay, here the area is nothing but A equal to pi by 4 d square. So pi by 4 d square, d value is given in the problem itself, 0.3 meter. Substitute here 1000 into pi by 4, 0.3 the whole square into u, which is equal to mass flow rate is 1. Okay, now find out the value of u. U is 0.14 meter per seconds. Substitute this U value in Reynolds number equation, you will get UD divided by nu. So the U value is 0.014 into diameter is 0.3 divided by kinematic viscosity is 1.006 into 10 to the power minus 6. So the Reynolds number value will be 4174, which is greater than 2300. So flow is turbulent flow. So for turbulent flow, Reynolds number is less than 10,000 value. So since it is less than 10,000, the Nusselt number equation nu equal to 0.023, Reynolds number power 0.8, Pr power n. Okay, here the n value is 0.4 since it is a heating process, because the inlet temperature is 10 degrees Celsius, outer temperature is 30 degrees Celsius. So it is a heating process, so n equal to 0.4. Substitute all the values, just find out the value of nu equal to 39.5, which is equal to hd divided by k. You have the value of h and k, just find out h value equal to 78.60 watt per meter square Kelvin. Okay, now you know the formula Q equal to mcp del T, mcp into Tm naught minus Tmi. From this equation, find out the Q value, which is equal to 83.56 into 10 to the power 3 watts. Now you have, you know another equation for Q, that is Ha into Tw minus T mean. Now you have, you know the value of Tw, T mean, H value and Q value. Find out the area is equal to area value, and area is equal to pi into D into L. From this equation, you know, from this equation you know the area value, and substitute the area value here, and which is equal to pi d L. Find out L value as 18.79 meters. So that's all, that is the answer, right? So thank you for watching the video.